So anywhere near Area 51, you shouldn't be peeping into the sky looking for UFOs. Don't waste your time with that bad news. Instead, try looking for giant jets. But what are these giant jets? For the start of the episode, hi everyone, this is Sushay and welcome to my channel. Area 51, formerly known as Detachment 3 Air Force Flight Test Center, is a highly classified government place located in southern Nevada, which according to FBI dates back to 1955. The reason you're familiar with Area 51 because many say that after a UFO crash nearby in Roswell, New Mexico, many people say that it is a research base for aliens or maybe stealies. The Roswell incident occurred on a stormy July night in 1947 when a lightning took down a disc-shaped spaceship or something in Roswell, New Mexico. People started claiming it as an alien spaceship. Keeping that wild theory apart, in 2030, the US government acknowledged it as a real place but as a spy government plane program. BBC people tried to shoot a documentary over there of that place. But the security observed it and arrested them at gunpoint. They said they have orders to kill people who come there without their permission. They even said that they are not allowed to take photos from the satellite even. As the government is maintaining this project so secretly, people started thinking that as a something mysterious place and craze has started. But what is the history of Area 51? In 1850, Nevada desert, people came to know that there is lead and silver. Soon they started mining. Nearly up to 70 years, they mined the earth by digging underground. Soon, during Second World War, US needed a secret military base to develop their weapons. A secret place means no one should know the place. It should be in between mountains and should be far away and underground. As they were searching for this type of place, they felt Groom Lake in Nevada desert is the blessed place because there was already underground construction because of miners and it is between mountains. But because of the 1947 Roswell incident, people started thinking it as an alien base. Lieutenant Walter Hoard, named ex-military officer, after his death, his affidavit was found in which he wrote, "The spaceship which was found during Roswell incident was a real alien spaceship and in that two aliens were died." A mechanical engineer who worked in Area 51 from 1966 to 1979 said that he and his teammates were connected to the alien by using telepathic technology and they communicated with him. He said the alien's name is J-Dot and he is in grey color. In 1989, Bob Reza, in an interview with BBC channel, told that "I am an ex-employee of Area 51. I work in 54th facility and I saw real 9 spaceships. By doing reverse engineering to that spaceships, we have been trying to adopt that technology." In addition to this, Bob Reza told that there was an element with atomic weight 150 which was found in the fuel of that aircraft. He told that this element's name is unipentium. But the speciality is, this unipentium element was found 14 years after his interview. However, multiple times a day, a small fleet of 737s fly in and out of McCarran International Airport, Las Vegas. These planes, which display only a registration number and a red stripe on a white fuselage, are known as Janet Jets. Once these Janet jets enter special airspace zone, they change their frequencies and get entirely different names. You can see 6 different Janet jets taking off and landing in McCarran International Airport, Gold Coast or the restricted terminal. The planes set off for many places in the secret Air Force range, which includes Nevada National Security Site. It's here where US had tested more than 900 nuclear weapons. Primarily, Area 51 is a developing site for world technology and US military and Air Force. They are developing the world's most advanced cutting-edge technology like telepathy, teleportation and extraterrestrial experiments. Presently, if you want to see Area 51 closely, then you have to climb Tikabu Peak, which is 42 kilometers away from Area 51. And from there, you have to look through telescope or binoculars. So friends, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give this video a like and share this video as much as possible so that everyone gets to know about this place. And subscribe to my channel for finding more interesting videos like this one. Meet you in the next video. Bye.